Just want to always make sure you're using some kind of vise here. Basically, the area that we're going to get into is around where the this phone call. We're going to get into this area here where the turbine, where the turbine normally sits. It sits like this. You don't really have to worry about all this material here. You can take out as much as you want because the turbocharger itself sits behind in here. So basically, you can take out as much material as you want. But you know, we're just going to concentrate right around this area here. We're just going to port and polish all this area here. So what I've got here is a few different types. I'm basically using a sanding cartridge right now. I have some grinding stones, and the grinding stones are aluminum oxide. I have a couple different sanding discs. I think this is like 30 grit or something like that, and it goes all the way up to like 150 grit. There really is no, you know, right or wrong way to do this when you're porting cast iron. The best way, obviously, is to start with if you're doing any major porting. I mean, if you really, really, really want to make cast iron, you really want to take some material out. The best thing to do is to use a carbide tip. But I don't have one right now, so I'm using sanding wheels, and as you can see, it's doing pretty well. So this is the inlet here. We're gonna go to the exhaust outlet side, and you can take a look at that. And you're just gonna wanna get in with a die grinder. Show it how it's done. So this is the final product. This is the TD04, I believe 13T, might be a 14T maybe. Whoa! So what I did is I ported and polished on the intake side of the exhaust housing. Took a good probably, I don't know, 3-4 millimeter from the inside here. This will still match up with the gasket. You can see on the outside here, there's still a good millimeter around here where the gasket goes. So what I did essentially is just open this up, allow exhaust gas to enter into the exhaust side a little bit more freely. On the actual exhaust side, this is big time. So I took, I don't even know, I just kept porting and porting and porting, but there used to be a step that was around in here. I don't know if it's still on the other video. There used to be a huge step that was around in here, and basically I just kind of ported that all away. And this from the camera angle in here, let me try to hold this up with my stomach belly, from the camera angle here, it probably looks like it's a little choppy. And looks like it isn't smooth, but if I feel this with my thumb, completely smooth. So the whole purpose is to really to open this up and allow it to be more efficient for exhaust gas to escape a little bit more efficiently, thereby having a more efficient turbo without actually, you know, doing much of anything. So this will be completely bolt on for any Subaru Legacy owners and Subaru WRX owners. Hit me up if anybody wants to buy it. I'll be putting it up for sale on eBay. And this came actually from a WRX of a guy that I know that races just does autocross, and he took it off his Subaru with probably he owned it for probably about a year, so maybe like 12,000 miles, something like that, 12 to 15,000 miles, and it actually performs flawlessly. I was with him when we took the turbocharger off, and there's no issues with the turbo driving the car. He actually never used to drive autocross with his turbocharger, so it actually, the car was completely stock when he took it off. So, like I said, if anybody's interested in a turbocharger, hit me up. Otherwise, it would be going for sale on the eBays. Peace out.